Gurudevate Vasudevaya. Vandeham Sri Gurum Sri Yuta Padakamalam Sri Gurum Vaishnavamscha Sri Rupam Shagrayatam Shahagana Raghunatanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savatutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padam Shahagana Lalita Sri Vishakam Vitamscha Mukam karoti vachalam pangum langayate girim yat kripatam ahang vande siguru dinatarenam. Parece que iba la luz oscura le hizo bien. Siddhanta Sarasvati Thakur Prabhupada ki jai. Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Thakur ki jai. Bueno, si tuviera yo un brazo de 3 metros, podría alcanzar los libros que hay por allá. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. So, we're reading today from the Srimad Bhagavatam with the commentary of Vishvanatha Chakravarti Thakur. It's very interesting because usually we read with the commentaries of Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, who is our supreme introducer of the Srimad Bhagavatam to the world. But all the other commentaries of all the other acharyas are also very important and very interesting. And therefore we can always keep learning and keep learning, keep learning. Vaishvanaram yati vyayasa gata shushumnaya brahma patena sochisa viduta kalkota harer udashtat prayati chakram nipasai shumaram. O king, the yogi, having gone by the path of Brahmaloka, goes to Vaishvanara by means of the ether, through the luminaries of the Shushumna Nadi. Being freed from all desires, he then approaches the Shishumara constellation above, which is related to the Lord. Commentary. First, they go to the presiding deity of fire, Vaishvanara, by means of the Akasha, Vihayasha, through the Sushumna Nadi, by the path to Brahmaloka. Brahmapatena. That nadi is located outside the body since it is filled with luminary, Sochisa. Having given up all impurities, viduta kalka, not being attached to anything, they proceed to the circle of stars located higher in the form of a dolphin, which is related to the Lord. That circle starts with stars such as Aditya, Purnavashu, and ends with a Dhruva star. This is the level of Swarga. This is described in Srimad Bhagavatam. At the tail of Shishumara is the pole star. Its body extends around the sky, following the path of the sun, with the 27 constellations situated on parts of the body. Now here's one thing we have to learn. The Vedas, their precision works. They give us information about the astronomy, astrology, definitions about the nadis, the marmas. Imagine the marma science. This is actually coming from the Vedas, from the Ayurveda principles. Marma science is where acupuncture comes from, where digipuncture comes from. It is referring to all the marmas which you have in your body. You see, your body is a very sophisticated instrument. Not sophisticated, supremely sophisticated. That's the macrocosmos and the microcosmos. So when you're talking about the microcosmos, you're talking about the cosmos of the physical body, the microcosmos. But there's another microcosmos, and that is the genetic cellular cosmos. And then there is the epigenetic cosmos. The epigenetic cosmos is the most amazing because it refers to the underlying laws and principles which are actually governing everything. And that is the level of quantum physics, or it is where we reach beyond what the eye can see. Epigenetics is very interesting. Now we were in yoga festival and we met with a great scientist, Bruce Lipton, who is one of the top scientists on epigenetics. When you're talking about epigenetics, you're talking about something which the latest science magazines in the world, they are talking about that. So if you talk to any common man in the street, you say, hey, you know by epigenetics, he goes, no? What are you talking about? What is epigenetics? But epigenetics is a proven thing. For example, Bruce Lipton explained to us in his classes that the diseases which we are getting are coming from the consciousness distortion. They are not coming from what you could call genetic problems. Of course, the environmental situations do influence the genes at some point, but it's not the genes. The genes in itself, they don't carry any of that. Said almost 99%, you can say the genes are just information transporters, and they are not the cause. So he said the cause, like Ayurveda says, there are three reasons why you become sick: anxiety, dirt, contamination, and eating too much. These are the three reasons for becoming sick. This is interesting, no? And we all know how eating too much can really make you sick. So therefore eating is a very important thing, and not being in an environment of contamination is a very important thing. So Bruce Lipton, he has that science very deeply down, and he was giving us very good information in this. So epigenetics is the, it is the, you know, macrocosmos, microcosmos, cell cosmos, and epigenetic cosmos. So we are talking about four cosmos of highest sophistication. Not only your hair is an indication of highest sophistication. I mean, we all have this nice hair and we are pretty happy about it, no? Except Brahmacharis, they just want to cut it off, you know? But they say, oh, what a big heck, what a disturbance. But everybody else is so happy with their hair, flowing like this, flowing like that, like this. People are very much into hairs. Huh? So that's why it was so popular in the 60s, the musical Hair. Huh? It's all about hair, 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 hair. Huh? And you know, no? Like one time the woman said to Prabhupada, can I also cut my head? And Prabhupada said, no, Krishna doesn't like ugly gopis. So the hair makes you beautiful also. Huh? Hair is something beautiful. Hair flows, hair is soft, hair has so many colors. So sometimes we have too much hair, sometimes we have not enough hair, but it's a big topic, you know? But this is nothing. When you come to the cells, when you come to the genes, when you come to the epigene level, then you will really understand how this world works. How the higher consciousness influences lower things. How consciousness is the driving factor of everything. And that therefore we have to make sure our consciousness is Krishna consciousness. It's very important. According to the development of your consciousness, you get the result. So if you have a bad consciousness, then you will get a bad result. So whose fault? The genes? No. The genes not. Who is responsible is you yourself. You have not looked after your consciousness. You have eaten too much, you have indulged too much, you have slept too much, you have not come to class. Arjuna, come to class! Oh, sorry. That is when you sit behind the column. So, anybody else come to class? We were supposed to paint this one yesterday. We still have a lot of the work which is not finished. And Prishni is going out today because now Gopurnima coming. The cleaning is so incredible. There's so much work to be done. Plus all the rain yesterday. It's a big job there. A big job. Anyhow, we have the good luck in Mayapur. After the rain comes the sun. Everything dries. But we also have prediction there more rain today, no? Anyhow. So, talking about the sophistication of creation, you see, God is so wonderful. He has shown us His opulence in every way, in every level. Anybody who thinks that this world was created by some accident or by some... He's out of his mind. He's simply ignoring the facts. He's ignoring the signs. He's ignoring the wonders of creation. It is just as stupid as if you go in front of a 747 airplane and say, oh, there must have some big meteor fell on an iron mine, and after that meteor I hit the iron mine and the pong. All of a sudden, the 747 airplane was there. That is as intelligent as to say that there's no intelligent design. This is just as stupid. You follow? There's no question, there's no comparison whatsoever. You cannot say that everything comes from nothing or accident. It does not make sense. There's not one proof, there's not one hint in the creation that something comes from nothing. It's just as stupid to say, let us cook today by just throwing the sabjis in the kitchen. Just throw them, don't put them there, just throw them in the, all the boga you throw in the kitchen, and 2 hours later you come and get the prashad is ready for offering. I mean, you gotta be a bloody idiot if you make such a proposal. So the scientists nowadays who are neglecting the fact of intelligent design, they are bloody idiots. They are simply want to say, no, we the scientists, we reign supreme. What we do, nobody can tell us anything. It's very, very nonsense. Sanatana Dharma tells us of creator and creation. Srimad Bhagavatam is creation, sub-creation. And they put a name to it. Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva. They put a name to it. They put a name to everything. The Vedas put a name to everything. The Vedas are very scientific. You know Sachin? Where's Sachin? Oh, there. It's so scientific. Everything they say. This is Sattvagun. This is Tamagun. This is Rajagun. They say this is the influence of, like in Ayurveda, Kapha, Pitta, Vata. They have a name for everything in the Vedas. For Shilpa Shastra. They can make a temple. A big, big temple. Biggest temple in the world. And you know how they make them? Without cement. No cement they're using. They knew how to construct this ferro-concrete. You just throw some heavy, heavy cement and stick some metals inside. Yeah, that is the brutish architecture. They're really for the brutes. These people, they were carving the stones. This comes here, this comes there, and then it goes click. Next one, on top. They were constructing most amazingly in Tanjore, Brihadishvara. The Tanjore Brihadishvara temple. This is something like 80 meters high. And on top of it, it has one stone carved, which is weighing 80 tons. 80 tons. 80 meters high on this Brihadishvara Mandir. Nobody knows how they got that stone up there. They cannot even fantasize. The BBC made one attempt. They said they must have made like 80 meter high. They must have made a ramp which goes so far, like 2 kilometers, and they must have pushed the rock up by elephants. So you can imagine how heavy that ramp must have been. And then in the end they had to take away the ramp again. They have no idea how the Indians made Brihadishvara Mandir. With all the science, and today with the cranes, those cranes, they cannot lift 80 tons. No way. No way they can do that. And all the big rock is carved intricately. Still missing here bamboo to cover these pipes. So that is the reality of science. Now some idiot is going to tell me a Brihadishvara Mandir was constructed by some rock falling from the sky? Come on, go to the madhouse or just shut up. Just shut up, you stupid fools. Listen to the Vedas. The Vedas have power to speak. They give the name to it. What is the name? Shakti. Divine Shakti. And by divine Shakti, everything is analytically organized. Everything is in perfection, divine Shakti. And you yourself are divine Shakti. But not you are the divine Shakti. You are the son and the product of the divine Shakti. If anybody say, I am my mother. Huh? Anybody can say that? I am my mother? Let me get a stick and hit you. Are you really your mother? Come on, tell me, are you your mother? No, I'm not my mother. Okay, now we talk. What nonsense. This world is so crazy. Nobody is his own mother. Mother is superior. And mother is giving life to you. Mother is bringing you up. And that is our greatest fortune. So just like we are not our mother, we are also not our creators. So if you say there's nobody above you, you are really a Pashandi. What is the shloka in Bhagavad Gita? I forget. Duskriti na muda. You know this? Namang duskriti no muda. Look up that verse in Gita. Naradama. I learned that verse, but my memory. This is a very important verse to understand. That's where Krishna gives us the sauce. Huh? He tells us who we really are and what's really going on. Namam duskritino muda. Prapatyante naradama. And then, forgot. So, this is what the Bhagavatam does. Bhagavatam is a scientific. You got it? Mayaya apagrita jnana asuram bhavam ashritam. Please write it for me on the paper later so I can remember my work. Now the translation, please.
Those miscreants who are trusted to the lowest among mankind, whose knowledge is stolen by the illusion, partake of the atheistic nature of demons, do not surrender unto me.
Again, loud.
Those miscreants who are grossly foolish, who are lowest among mankind, whose knowledge is stolen by illusion, and who partake of the atheistic nature of demons, do not surrender unto me.
When I call them bloody idiots, it's really soft. That's what Krishna says. Partake of the nature of demons, whose knowledge has been stolen by illusion, who are the lowest of mankind, those miscreants. And I'm sorry, they're the ones who run the universities of colonialism. That's why I tell the devotees, you don't have to study in any of these silly universities. If you want to get knowledge, then study the Vedas under a Vedic Acharya. They have this. or study the ancient wisdom from those who have ancient wisdom. It is 1,000 times better to study in Vrindabhumi and to become a sadhu, learned sadhu, than to spend. Now, of course, sometimes we have devotees like our Ladini. Where's Ladini? Busy. Our Ladini is a PhD in sophisticated influence of chemistry, biochemistry. Ladini is a star. Ooh, she knows so much. And she's using that for Krishna. And she's a humble devotee. Amazing. In the material world, she'll be, oh, Mrs. PhD. Oh, Mrs. Scholar. And here she's helping cooking in the kitchen and like that. So we can have that mundane knowledge when we surrender it to Krishna. But if we get this knowledge and we become puffed up by this knowledge, then everything is lost. Then we become Naradama. Mayaya apagrita gyan. All the knowledge is stolen by illusion, by idiots having idiot ideas. And the idiot ideas is that there's no higher truth above me. I am the highest truth myself. My dear fool, you don't know where you come from, you don't know where you're going, and you say there's no truth above you. I'm very sorry. You are very deplorable. Now, when I preach, normally I don't speak that strong, because maybe they get offended and they run away and will not take prasada. So we are a little bit softer. We say, yes, the materialistic way of life is taking us nowhere. Everybody's unhappy. Are you guys unhappy? Yeah. It's true. Everybody's unhappy when he's an illusion. So I'm so thankful to Srila Prabhupada for giving us the truth. Srila Prabhupada, he gave us such a solid information. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. He gave us the basis of Krishna consciousness. All you can read here about Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur is the reason why this movement existed and expanded. Subhash Chandra Bose is considered one of the greatest personality of Bengal. He was a military man, and he went in the defense of Indian national freedom. But he did not free India from the neo-colonial education system. He is considered a hero because he took a gun and started shooting. Any gunda is doing the same. Any gunda takes a gun and shoots, and this is not a big deal. And as a matter of fact, that's why Gandhi is so highly appreciated, because he's accomplishing his goal without killing people. That is a higher knowledge, a higher strategy. And Vaishnavism and Hinduism follows that strategy if possible. I mean, if there's absolutely no way out, then we also have to go to defend the higher values. So, the Srimad Bhagavatam here is telling us about the Sushumna. That is the Nadi, talking about the ways how the yogis can go to Brahmaloka. Very interesting, no? Srimad Bhagavatam, it's yoga. Yoga knowledge is there. And it also says that Daivi Esha Gunamayi Mama Imayadu Ratya Yamameva Ye Papatyante Mayam Mitang Taranti Te. What it says, this material world is very difficult to overcome. Very difficult. But if you surrender to me, you can easily cross beyond it. So Krishna makes a point that all those who try to make the yoga perfection today, they will not get very far. That is not the process of this age, yoga. But the yoga is good to attracting the people to the Vedic culture. Yoga has become a world attraction, World Yoga Day. More and more people in the world say, yes, yoga is very good, even though they don't know what it is all about. They think yoga is some exercise or something. No, not at all. Yoga is alive, so therefore I'm coming from the International Yoga Festival, and I tell you, nobody said that yoga is just asanas. No! The International Yoga Festival is establishing that yoga is this path of Sanatan Dharma, of going to the highest. Now we have Ayush, we have a ministry in India which makes sure that yoga is not misunderstood to be a sport or gymnastic or something like they invented. I forgot the name. Lapis. Pilates. Stupidity Pilates. I mean, you can move your legs, you can do anything with your body, you can become like some people that go to the circus and they become like rubber. They can go anywhere with their bodies there. So, but it's not the idea. We don't want to get the rubber body. We want to get spiritual consciousness. So the circus people, they're much better in yoga than some of the yogis. But of course, yogis also. But you cannot get to Goloka Vrindavan with your yoga. That is the important thing. Where do you get with your yoga? To Swarga? How far can you go with your yoga? Brahmaloka? Sattvaloka? Tapalo? Where can you go with your yoga? If you go anywhere. Because many of the yogis are just interested in the yoginis. And after yoga comes boga. So there are no more yoga. So in this way, it's not such a cheap thing. The Veda's not cheap, it's not for everybody. Krishna says, Namang Duskriti no Muda. Are you a Muda? Can any Hindi speaking person that can understand the word Muda?
Muda.
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 What does it mean Muda in Hindi? Nothing.
Muda is a one thing.
Muda. Muda means in Bengali.
In Bengali. So Bengali is more close to Sanskrit than Hindi. Muda means?
Who have no knowledge.
It's a fool.
Yes.
It's a bloody fool. That's a Muda. So that's what the Bhagavad Gita says. So if somebody calls you Muda, here in Bengal, people are not happy, no? It's like an insult. But according to the Bhagavad Gita, those who do not believe in the higher truths, they're mudas. So we are talking about a slim line. We have a very slim line of going into the right direction, getting the best answer for our difficulties. What is that? The answer is that when you surrender to Krishna, then things become better. Everything depends on surrender to Krishna. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti explains, first they go to the presiding deity of fire, Vaishvanara, by means of the Akasha, Vihayasha, through the Sushumna Nadi, by the pass of Brahmaloka, Brahmapatena. That nadi is located outside the body since it is filled with luminaries, sochisa. Having given up all impurities, viduta kalka, not being attached to anything that proceed to the circle of stars located together in the form of a dolphin, which is related to the Lord. That circle stars starts with stars such as Adityas, Punarvasu, and ends with the Dhruva star. Now listen to this. What an amazing information, how the yogi, through his yogic process, can transport himself to other planetary systems. Where do you find such information? This is much higher information than the NASA can provide. And they're spending billions of dollars on sending rockets here and there. But here the Bhagavatam is giving us this deep of an insight in cosmology, in astrology, in karmology, the knowledge of the karma, how the karma interacts with us. I just created a new word, the karmology. Uh-huh. It's a nice word, no? Do you know karmology? Actually, you're not supposed to study karmology, because Krishna says that nobody can understand the karma. Karma is much too complicated. So therefore we should not try to understand the karma. We should just understand the principle of karma. But if I want to know why your face is not looking like Japanese, why you are not 2 meters 20 high, why you are such a foolish questioning in the karma science. But everything has a science. Why is this sannyasi more tall than this sannyasi? Huh? I mean, we can ask this question, but it's an idiot question. We should not ask this. Entering into karma, no? Why is he white? Why is he black? Why is he green? Why is he yellow? It's for idiots. Why is she a woman? Why is she a man? What is this? We are all eternal spirit souls. We are not one or the other. We are servants of the truth. So therefore, very, very important is this divine science. Divine science is very, very valuable. And this is what we are studying. The Vedas give us those informations. You know, how to reach the pole star. I mean, such an information, and what type of consciousness, and where the yogi can go, and what happens when he does his great special austerity to control the life airs in his body, and he's sitting there, and he's breathing. He's over-oxygenizing his brain, which has an intoxicating effect. You feel like, hi. Have to pump a little bit more. Yeah, that's pranayama, my dear. So, actually, you know, there's so many things to know about the world and the creation and everything. It's amazing. And all this is Vedic knowledge. All this the rishis have known. They knew how to do things which we don't know nowadays. Like, for example, making a brahmashtra. I mean, fortunately, we don't know how to do that, because I can imagine, you know, two devotees from South America, they're fighting here in Mayapur, and they're throwing brahmastras at each other. Fortunately, they don't know how to do that, no? They can only go, and then at the end they have to see, well, if we don't work together, we will go nowhere. But imagine we have so much power that we can throw brahmastras at each other. God. Huh? biting. Therefore, Krishna removed the Brahmastra power from the Vedic practitioners for this age, to just make sure the temples they can survive. So, but this divine knowledge is there. It's incredible knowledge. But we don't know it. We think we have to watch television. We think that we will get something by taking a title from university. But that title will not give you anything. That title will not give you happiness. This title will not give you jnana. This title will not give you humility. What will that title give you? Nothing. Actually, we have to give an applause to our museum designers and museum makers because we had such a storm last night and nothing fell apart of the museum. So that must be given a good applause to the workers who make this. And please keep it up like this because I think, you know, people are tired. People are tired from reading. They don't read anymore. So people just go, oh, your museum, okay, nice. But they didn't read even one of the texts. Huh? So, but this is very valuable text and it's a very, we worked so hard to make this museum. Because for us, writing in English is very hard. Because we don't know to speak English nicely. We know something called pigeon English. You know, like the pigeon? Paloma English. I think this could be this. Like this. But we have, that's our English, pigeon English. And still we make a museum of Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur and get it translated and get it corrected. Now it should also be in Bengali. Because the Bengalis, they don't know how to read English, but at least we got it in English. Now we should make another one in Spanish, so that we can have the proper museum. Good morning. Did you have a good bath this night? Oh, so sorry. Did you finally get dry?
Not yet. I turned the fan on.
But no, did you get to sleep dry?
Yes, now yes.
Okay. So this is the science of the Vedas. So amazing. And we have the greatest scientists of the Vedas giving classes every night here, just a few steps away. Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj is giving classes there. And Vrindavan, oh, this place is so full of incredible places, incredible love. Today is Gaur Purnima Adivas, the day before the appearance of Lord Chaitanya. I was here in Gaur Purnima. I was here when it was the first time lunar eclipse after 500 years of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's birth. And we spent the whole night inside the Panchameni, watching the eclipse take place and chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So, very important this constellation of Gaur Purnima. When the light comes down, and actually Gaur Purnima, this is when the full moon of Gauranga arises to give hope and vision to the world. And we have even our Ramesh Bhai here, Sachin Bhai, these very wonderful friends of mine. They're real Sanatan Dharmis. For doing for the truth, they can do anything. Very helpful, they have always been. to us, even though we have not had much time together. Life is difficult too. But we are very happy that you took time to come to this Gaur Purnima here. Last not least, our Vinda Society is your family society. No? So keep it in your family. The Bhai family will always protect the foreign devotees in the Vinda family. Tike? Okay. Because India works like that. That when you do something, generation after generation, they continue what father did. Then it is very becomes a holy tradition. No? So, I am, you know, I actually deeply in my heart admire this Vedic culture. And then they in England, they had something. They say, England, with all thy faults, I love thee. That was the saying, England, because the British Empire was very powerful. Actually, nasty empire, but that was the saying. And everybody was like, even today, Britain. Britain has more than 2 million Indians living there. So the Britain was very, very, very fortunate to get 2 million Sanatan Dharmis to live there nowadays. So that's why they have big temples in Britain, the Hindu culture in Britain. I'm working with the Vishwa Hindu Parishad in Britain. They made an educational book for what is Hinduism, very first class book. I just don't have time to write. I need to write so much. I need to be part of so many type of activities. But anyhow, we are translating this Sanatan Dharma book of Hinduism to Spanish now, because we are going to go in every country to the Minister of Culture and Education, and we're going to show him, this is Hinduism, and you accept it officially. Officially you accept, this is the oldest tradition, and not just like they do in it in the religious studies. They have Hinduism, like a little small section. It is being taught by Christians what is Hinduism. Mm-hmm. And it makes the Hindus look like fools. And that is the educational information supplied about Hinduism, like in countries like New Zealand or Australia or whatever. So we are going to go with the book of education and going to establish that from Vishwa Hindu Parishad in connection with, of course, our Prabhupada's incredible contribution, because Srila Prabhupada's contribution is far higher than what the Vishwa Hindu Parishad has produced. Prabhupada has given the whole science. The booklet about Hindu education is like a booklet of 150 pages with many pictures of showing what are the mudras, what are the yantras, what is an Agnihotra Yagya, what are the main temples, like that, no? Giving like a historical clarification, which is very valuable. Describes the Vedas, what the different Vedas, which areas they're dealing with. So this is one of our jobs now, to establish the Hinduism education and the practitioners of Hinduism to be a valid process of self-realization and religious contemplation, which deserves any kind of respect and support from the religious or from the government system, just as any other religion deserves it as well. Who's going to help me with that? Thank you, Prem Kumari. You are always saying I help you. So, who else? Because I'm forming a group of 11 representatives in every country of the Vishwa Hindu Parishad. This is my seva I have. 11 representatives I need in every country, and none of them can be fighters. No, these guys get out of my way. Sometimes I have to tolerate them because they are part of the Vaishnava family. But for administration, forget it, you know. These nagging people who always fight with each other, they help you in nothing. They just bring the energy down. So therefore, even my friend Vigyanananda Maharaj from the Vishwa Hindu Parishad, now he is the General Secretary, Joint General Secretary. He said, make those committees, but don't let the fighting people inside. So it was direct instruction from that. I told him, yes, in my Easter Gosti, I also tried the same, to keep the fighters outside. But sometimes the fighters are good workers also. So sometimes you make, like, give the fighters some chance, but it only disturbs those who want to show I'm better than everybody else, and like that, wants to put down the others. That's nothing. That is not helpful. So I need you to help me. So Vasudeva, you are for Sweden, no? We're going to make a Vishwa Hindu Parishad there with our Indian friends. It's always good we have some Indian friends in the country also part of it. And we have the bylaws already. We have to just write it for the local law, adapting them to the local law, and then registering it. So that is there. Ooh, Prem Kumari. Prem Kumari is always... Aradhya, you're going to be part of it. Yes, accepted. Brahma, all... Mantra also, Kalki also, you also accepted. Anybody else is ready for this? I guess you don't speak very good English because you're not responding. Or maybe you have some kind of mental paralysis. Because after what I just said, if you don't want to be part of representing the higher values of our tradition in our different countries, then I don't know what are you practicing. Are you not practicing Sanatana Dharma? Are you not practicing the yoga process? So the thing is, volunteers is not easy to find people who are ready to make a sacrifice for a cause. You don't find the Vandana Shiva around every corner. You don't find the Mahatma Gandhi. You don't find the Satviji. You don't find an Atikikwa everywhere. They're very rare people who go out of their way to help others and to make things possible. Everybody wants to sit in the sofa. Potato chips. Popcorn. Popcorn and movie. So we have a big job to do. This is real. This is real knowledge. This is real gyan. But we want Vigyan. We don't want Gyan. We want Vigyan. What's the difference, Sachi? What's the difference between Gyan and Vigyan?
Gyan is about all the knowledges. And Vigyan we can do, which we can perform by doing it, by understanding it.
Yes, we also call it wisdom, applied knowledge in practical use, that's wisdom, otherwise it's just theory. How much knowledge you have? They go, oh, look at my bookshelf. They say, I have 300 books. Yeah, do you understand anything? No. Did you read them? No. In the West, when people want to show that they're learned people, they build a house, and then they need to have a library, but they have no library. Then they go to the bookstore and they tell, I need 8 square meters of books. Can you please sell me 8 square meters of books? Of course, they have to be the classical, have to be there, Schopenhauer, Shakespeare, and all these people. But you have no time to choose 8 square meters of books. That's the book. And of course, only rich people, because the books are expensive, no? So many pages, no? But the guy who buys the 8 square meters of books, he never looked at one of them. But then people come to his home and they see there's the bookshelves. Oh, this is your library? Yes. You know, we have to read a lot to get where you are, no? That is making a show. Now, let me ask you a question. How many of you know that people buy books by the square meter? Any bookseller, bookshop, they know that. That is the best of the clients they have.
Not only books, where they buy Ecopor inside and outside, just the book cover. Only the book inside is Ecopor, so it looks like.
But that part I have not seen yet.
you can buy it in the furniture shop, I guess.
Yeah, of course, there must be imitation of everything, so there must be also imitation of books. As long as you don't want an Ecopor Bhagavad Gita, please. Yeah. Oh, Govinda. So, Mahaprabhu has come and he has given us all this divine knowledge. How is it possible? How we were so fortunate. Mahaprabhu was a great scholar. From the very beginning of his life, he had a school. But after he met his guru, Ishwarapuri in Gaya, he came back and he chanted Gopi, 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 and his students said, please, what about Nyaya? He said, forget about Nyaya, we just want to become servants of Krishna. Oh, his students were so unhappy. Now we have to all become devotees. No more Nyaya knowledge. Mahaprabhu made it clear that all this knowledge in the mundane world, that knowledge will not help anybody. You have to get bhakti, you have to get wisdom. And if you find out this information about the constellations from the Srimad Bhagavatam, into which constellation you go at what time when you leave the body, yes? Do you want to know all that? And you have to look at the watch. When this is coming now, oh, the nadi is coming up for going to Swarga. Okay, Lampino. No? We don't recommend that. That yoga is not very safe. We recommend Antakale Chamangiva. Antakale Chamangiva. Kalevaram Yaprayati Samattamam Adinas. Look up this verse, please. Who knows this verse? Anta kale chaman eva. My dear sannyasi scholars, don't tell me you don't know this verse. Because at the moment of death, you will need it. The next verse is Yang Yang Bapis Malam Babam Tianti and Tikalevaram Tam Tami Vaiti Kautiya Sadata Bhava Bhavitaha Antakalecha Mangiva Nitya Mukta Antakalecha Mangiva
Malam Mukta Kalevaram.
Okay, read the whole thing.
Antakalecha Mam Eva Malam Mukta.
Slowly and loud.
Antakalecha Mam Eva Malam Mukta Kalevaram.
I missed this one word. Ante kalecha mangiva smanan muktva kalevana. Smanan muktva kalevana. Remember Krishna at the moment of death, you go to him. Have you not memorized this verse, Puri Maharaj? It means your brain is shut like mine. You're already forgetting. What about Giri Maharaj? What about this shloka?
Oh.
Yes. If you know it really in Spanish, it's good. But some key verses Prabhupada wanted us to know the original version also. We should not stop learning Sanskrit shlokas. And we should not stop cultivating our beautiful farms ecologically. That's another thing, you know. Like now we have so many organic tomatoes in our ashram. So many organic tomatoes. I'm so happy to see how Bon Maharaj has given us his organic growing vegetables here. This is an example. We should all grow our vegetables and go in a garden. Every day, make sure your organic vegetables are growing nicely. Then you can feed Krishna with good food and feed your devotees also with good food and not just with some chemical stuff which is tumor producing. You know what that's tumor producing? That is that thing which grows inside of you, which is not supposed to be there. And it looks like a Hollywood demon, like that, and it grows and grows and grows. And then somebody has to come and says, oh, you want to get rid of this tumor? Okay, then give me $3,000. Then he comes with a knife, he cuts you. There's this demon, and then you cut him. You take out this tumor from your body, but what made the tumor grow is still inside. He couldn't cut. That was all the poison you put in your body. So then you have $3,000 less, and he closes your body, and then you have no tumor, but then it is growing somewhere else again. So that is what is this tumor-producing food. So we don't want that. We should have organic food. We should make sure we are growing or we are buying from somebody who is growing organically. Time has come. Time has come. These tumors, they are greatly and necessarily by our wrong way of doing everything. And we can't say, oh, we are devotees of Krishna, therefore we will never get a tumor or anything. It's not true. Don't be in that illusion. And that is very expensive and very complicated when you have to be on dialysis. Who knows what is dialysis? One. Who does not know what is dialysis? out and lift your arms. Who does not know what is dialysis? Ramesh, you know what is dialysis? That is, you have to go every 3 days in a hospital, and they put your blood through a whole machine for 4 or 5 hours. They go, and then they put the blood back into you, and you can live for 3 more days. This is a horrible thing. That means when your kidney fails, then you have to go on dialysis or you have to die. And Srila Harijan Maharaj, he had kidney failure. And he was on dialysis for a while and he didn't want it anymore. And somebody proposed for him to give a kidney transfer. Even one devotee wanted to offer his kidney to Harijan Maharaj. But Harijan Maharaj said, no, when my body is finished, then it's time to go. So he left. We were very sad, but I agree with him. When the body fails, when we ruined this body, time to go. Get the next body and take better care of it. Hopefully next lifetime we'll eat organic food and not all this poison. Anyway, that's an individual decision, but that's the way. Hey, Goranga! Look who is here, our great devotee.
I am very happy that you have called to me.
Ah.
And another day, I have seen from my corridor that you are going there, and I have come here to see, and I heard that you went to country.
Yes, sit down, sit down. Goranga is one of our members, and he was all life big police inspector. But now he's only Harinam and no more.
But I am feeling troubled for my mental disease. Something.
Uh-huh. And this is your grandson?
No. He is my daughter's son. Daughter's.
So he's your grandson.
Now he is staying at Kharagpur, near Calcutta.
So you sit down. Anyhow, it is now 8:20, and we are coming kind of to the close, but let us read one more verse because it's so interesting. Tat Vishvanabhim Tvativartya Vishnur Aniyasa Virajanatmanaika Namaskritam Brahmavidam Upaiti Kalpayusha Yat Vibhuda Ramante. So passing the navel of Vishnu, the area of Swarga, with his very subtle, pure body, he alone arrives at the worshipable Mahaloka, in which sages who live for a Mahakalpa enjoy. Commentary. Passing through the circle of stars belonging to Vishnu, which is the navel of the universal form, Vishvanabhim, with a subtle body, which is very subtle, Aniyasa, and pure, Virajena, he alone, Eka, separate from others because he does not go to Swarga, arrives at Mahaloka, Brahmavidam, worthy of worship, Namaskritam, where the sages who live for a Mahakalpa, lifetime of Brahma, enjoy. My God, here's a real truffle journal. The Srimad Bhagavatam is describing to you how you can go to Brahmaloka or don't get down at Brahmaloka. Go to Mahaloka, because in Mahaloka the people living like Brahma. One kalpa they can enjoy in Mahaloka. You know, in Swarga Loka, it's not so long. Swarga is Indra Loka. Indra Loka, there's lots of politics going on. Sometimes Indra is kicked out. Sometimes Indra is made to be a servant of Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyaksha. Sometimes, no, Indra Loka is full of trouble. So you don't want to go there. So stay in the car. Stay in the transport of the yogic and go to Mahaloka. There you can stay for a lifetime of Brahma. Jai! You don't want to go. Nobody say Jai. Oh, said Santana. You don't want to go to Brahmaloka? No? Living one kalpa, enjoying. What do you say? What is your opinion, Vasudeva?
Ad Brahma Bhuvana Loka.
Oh, he's a Shastric scholar. What does that mean?
That all the places of this world, from the lowest to the highest, Brahmaloka, the places of misery and death, eventually.
Very important. So from the highest planet to the lowest planet, there's all places of misery. So then the Srimad Bhagavatam is cheating us by telling us that we can go to Brahmaloka? Or is testing us? What is your business? Let's see how it goes on. Ato anantasya muka nalena dandayamanam saniriksya vishvam niryati shideshvara yushtadishnyam yatvai parardhyam tat uparameshtyam. After this, seeing the three worlds, including Swarga, burning because of the fire emanating from the mouth of Ananta, he departs for Brahmaloka, which lasts two parardhas, and where there are flying vehicles used for perfect beings. Yep, finally we're going to get your own airplane. In America, they say everybody wants to fly his own airplane. Maybe you've heard about that. That's when you don't get along with the temple president. No, I don't like you tell me everything. I want my airplane. Is there a way? Well, sometimes there's a way. We open another temple. Then two people can fly the airplane. And when that's not enough, we open three temples. In Bogota, Colombia, we opened now 25 temples because there were 25 people needed an airplane. Now they're all happily flying around. Just we have to make sure they don't shock with each other when they fly around. So, after this, Atta, if he desires out of curiosity to stay there until the end of the day of Brahma, at the end of the day, seeing the three worlds burning, he departs from Mahaloka because of the heat and goes upward to Brahmaloka, Prameyashtyam. That lasts for the two parardhas, Brahma's life, in which there are space, vehicle, used for the perfected beings. So it's very interesting how it says there's space vehicle means when you get there, they will give you one hit vehicle. Just like we see the devas. The devas, they have different vehicles, no? For example, Lord Ganesh, I don't know what happened to him, but he got a mouse, a rat. He for his transport, he got a rat. Make it nice, look good, no? An elephant on a rat. The Vedas have good taste, no? Kartikeya has a peacock. He travels on a peacock. Vishnu comes on Garuda. Rama comes on a swan. Shiva, he didn't go for a bird. He took a bull, Nandi. But it's flying Nandi. And Indra, he travels on an elephant, king of heaven, Hyderabad. So, what vehicle you want to have? Are you one of those idiots who wants to have a Rolls Royce? You know, one of these horrible four-wheel all the contamination coming out? You want such a silly vehicle? Or maybe you want a Learjet, so you can fly everywhere. So what is it what you want? Here's the question. We have the travel catalog is open. You can choose your next destination. Come on. Don't minimize the invitation. You never before in your life anybody has offered to you to travel all these places. And everybody loves to travel. Next, na yatra shoko na jara na mityur na tiya na chot vegarite kutaschit yakchita toda kripa yanidim vidam duranta dukkha prabhavanu darshanat. In Brahmaloka there's no lamentation, old age, death, suffering or fear, except sufferings in the mind because of their compassion on seeing the influence of unsure multiple sufferings on the living entities ignorant of the path of Vaishnava Yoga. Now look at this, Prabhupada called it, here they call it Vaishnava Yoga. They are unaware, ignorant of the path of Vaishnava Yoga. This is a glorification of Satya Loka. This is Vishwanath Chakravarti saying. In that place there is no lamentation, old age, death, suffering or fear, except for sufferings in the mind. Why? How does? How does that arise? It is because of compassion arising from seeing the influence of unsurmountable sufferings. Sufferings of those in the three worlds who do not know the process of devotional yoga. This is praise in disguise for the great compassion of the inhabitants of Satya Loka. Well, we have to keep reading this. This is so interesting. It says everything about. The next verse says, then he attains the layer of earth without fear with the body of earth. Then the layer of water with the body of water. Then the layer of fire with the body of fire. In time he attains layer of air with an air body. And then the layer of ether, which is worshipped as a form of Paramatma. The yogi attains smell, taste, form, touch and sound, as well as all the actions of the various action senses. The yogi attains the layer of false ego in which the sense object, senses, mind and sense devatas are merged into the gunas of tama, rajas and sattva. He merges the false ego into the mahatattva layer. He then merges the mahatattva to the pradhan in which the gunas have stopped functioning. O king, being merged himself in his Swarupa along with Pradhana into the blissful unchanging form of Mahavishnu. With that termination he remains blissful. He who has attained this goal does not return to the material world. Vasudeva, being satisfied, described to Brahma long ago these two eternal paths to attain Brahman, described in the Vedas, which were asked by you. There are no other auspicious paths for those suffering in the material world, because this path produces prema for Bhagavan Vasudeva. If the unchanging Lord reviewed three times the Vedas completely with the intelligence and determined the process which produces prema to the self. Any questions, my dear? Ask your questions now. Or today we will go to Chaitanya Mahat and then walk from Chaitanya Mahat to Yoga Pit, and then we will return. Today this is still possible. Difficult but possible. Then tomorrow it will be impossible. We do everything here. But before that, I want that you take some breakfast now, and we should do 1 hour of seva. I want all the plastic pipes covered by mud. So we go dig out some mud from the lake area and cover, because there's open plastic pipes. You hit on those plastic pipes a furniture and it breaks. And then we have a big problem, so they should be covered. I wanted that we do everything. And of course, we have a little cleaning to do also after all this. I think this seat also got wet. Where did you leave that seat?
It was here. I didn't put, but I came in the morning and I saw it was here.
Okay. This stays here. Also, you make sure I get another of those seats for Vrindavan. We will not travel with this anymore. This stays here. Because it's crazy to travel with such a huge thing. But I was happy in Rishikesh to have it. An old man with the legs. Any questions? So now you know where to travel. Swarga, Maloka, Brahmaloka, Vaikuntha. There's much more. This is a lot of information there. Yes, my dear Giri Maharaj. Ten thirty. Approximately. At 10:30 you gotta be ready, then you get the final information. Because I will check with Vishnu Maharaj what time he is going. I need somebody to help me with my mail. I have a lot of letters and I can't answer them all. Somebody has to be like, I dictate, I can speak a letter quickly, but it's very difficult for me to write certain letters. Yes. We should immediately send to them the bylaws, and maybe after Gopurnima we have a meeting. That's a possibility. But mainly it will be in writing, because they're very technical points. And the technical points you don't get by listening. You have to see them written down, and then we have to act upon them.
Vishupad, Paramahansa, Paribhraya, Kacharya, Stotra, Sashima, Srila, Bhakta, Lok, Paravetan, Swami, Guru, Dapati, Bhavana, Ki.
Why you guys have no questions?